Sveiki, nam su pergalė. Panevėžio Lietkabelio komandos vyriausiai treneriai, Nedas Čianaka. Šiandienos rungtynės komanda laimėjo 84-87. Gerbiamas treneri, trumpą komentarą pasibaigus rungtynėms. Short comment about the game.
We know what kind of game we expected here.
Mes žinojom, kokių rungtynių turėjom laukti čia.
And I'm very proud of my players because we didn't give up the speed that we have only 8 players right now.
Ir nors turėjom 8 tik žaidėjus savo sudėtyje, aš labai didžiuojuosi savo komandą.
We play much more better defense in the second half.
Antroje pusėje žaidėm geriau puolime.
And only thing what I didn't satisfy is our defensive rebound.
Ir vienintelis dalykas, kas mane labai nudžiugino šiandieną, tai gynybinė atkovoti kamuoliai.
We will continue work hard and we will wait for injury players Wilson and Visaitis to be team more better.
Ir laukiam į komandą sugrįžtant Wilsono ir Jasaičio ir turėsim kur kas geresnį komandą.
Coach Dzūkija was winning in rebounds in the first half, but then your team made a comeback in rebounds. How was important to collect those rebounds in the second half?
Very, very, very important. Good point. And for sure we control the rebound in the second half. That's the one of the key factor for our victory.
Tai ir buvo vienas iš pagrindinių mūsų pergalės faktorių, jog mes kontroliavom kovą po savo krepšiais antroje žaidimo pusėje.
And at the beginning of the game we saw Dzūkija concentrating in their paint, guarding their paint. There were a lot of free space at the perimeter. How was it important to knock down those three pointers to have that?
Yeah, but it's the beginning of the game. Of course, every point is important, but we didn't play our game. Our game is not only shoot 3 points, and Dzūkija forced us to shoot 3 points.
Taip, tai nebuvo pagrindinis dalykas pirmoje pusėje surinkti taškus, ir tai nebuvo tai, kad buvo reikalinga, kad Dzūkija leido antroje žaidimo pusėje mums mesti, pirmoje žaidimo pusėje mesti 3 taškus ir po jų pagriebti kamuolį.
Okay, you know, when you start, you just talk. When you start with a 3-point shot, in one moment, 3-point shot, you stop to make, and you didn't control rebound, you're not in rhythm, and you are in problem, like we were.
Taigi, spaudos konferencijoje dalyvauja Alytaus Dzūkijos komandos vyriausiasis treneris Andrejus Urlepas. Gerbiamas treneris, trumpą komentarą pasibaigus rungtynėms.
Congratulations for Lietkabelis. Again, very tough loss for us. This was our game. We didn't use that in the third quarter, what was there for us. At the end, one missed free throw, one box out, decided about everything.
Sveikinu Lietkabelio komandą. Vėl sunkios rungtynės ir sunkus pralaimėjimas. Tai buvo mūsų rungtynės. Deja, pabaigoje vienas pramestas metimas, vienas neatitvėrimas ir nulėmė rungtynių baigti.
Coach, what happened during the fourth quarter when you got the lead, your team got the lead, but then Lietkabelis made a comeback?
We were up 65-60 and then they made 3 and 2 plus 1. It was just we missed really open shots. For sure, our free throw shooting was not good, and they made that. They made when was the most important, we missed when was the most important.
Taip, tuo metu prie rezultato 65-60 Lietkabelis pataikė 3 taškį, pataikė 2 taškį su bauda, o mes nepataikėm laisvų metimų.
Dzūkija played a lot of overtimes this season. What's happening during their overtimes? Maybe the lack of experience for half of the young team?
No, it's not that young team. It's we played 7 overtimes. Out of 7 overtimes, we won just 1. What is really bad. What happened again? Like, we had chances, we had opportunities. We missed like really open shots. they made, that's that. And at the end, just one box out would be last offense for us. We didn't box out. They made two free throws. It's hard. It's
Ne dėl to, kad esam jauna komanda, tačiau, kaip žinia, šį sezoną žaidėm 7 pratesimus, iš jų laimėjom 1. Taip, turėjom kiekvienose rungtynėse šansą, bet mes nepataikėm, varžovai pataikė, taip gavosi, kaip gavosi.